We now see how to use the Hoare triple to define parts of a programming language. We don't use this material formally, but it does explain what goes on informally in the thought processes when programming. We start off with the if-else statement, asking the question, how can we know that executing the if-else statement beginning with precondition Q true will terminate with postcondition R true? We draw a flaw chart of this if-else statement with an assertion on each edge. Q is on the incoming edge, R is on the outcoming edge, Q and B is on the edge with B being true, and Q and not B is on the edge with B being false. Evidently, we have to show that executing S1 with Q and B true terminates with R true, and similarly for the case when B is false. Thus, from this flowchart, we can write down the Hoare triple for if-else. To prove that executing the if-else statement with Q true ends with R true, show that executing S1 with Q and B true terminates with R true, and executing S true with Q and not B true terminates with R true. This should be self-evident, common sense. If R is to be true after execution of the if-else statement, we have to be sure it is true whether B is true and S1 is executed, or B is false and S2 is executed. Or B is false and S2 is executed. Suppose we want to prove that executing S1, S2, starting with Q true, terminates with R true. This requires showing that each of S1 and S2 does its job. But first we have to find out what their jobs are. We have to find an assertion A that acts as a postcondition for S1 and a precondition for S2. Based on this, we can write the Hoare triple to prove that execution of S1, S2 beginning with Q true ends with R true. We have to know that executing S1 with Q true terminates with A true, and executing S2 beginning with A true terminates with R true. Let A and B be Boolean expressions. A implies B, written like this, is true if whenever A is true, B is also true. Here is an example, which is obviously true. When we write two assertions in a row, we mean that the first implies the second. This may seem silly, but there are real cases where such situations arise. And in such situations, we have to show that the first assertion implies the second. In this case, it's obvious. There are two general forms for this situation. One where the two assertions appear before the statement, and one where they appear after the statement. And for each, here is how we write a definition of a Hoare triple, including implication. In one case, and the other case.